Hello children, how are you all? Children, in the last session, we have done the textbook work of lesson number 14, The Big Enormous Turnip, up to the page number 118. Now today, let us do the remaining textbook work of this lesson. So, take out your English textbook New Voices, page number 119. Be ready with your eraser and sharpen pencil. So children, have you opened page number 119? Now draw a sleeping line and write today's date on it. Okay? Let's read the question. Use the word fan to build words. Now children, these are two word fans. Okay? Now first, you have to take these two given letters P, U, and then you have to add these two given letters in it, L L. So P U L L, let's write here P U L L. Now which word is formed here? Which word is formed? Pull. Yes, P U L L, pull. Like this we have to build or form words from given letters. Okay, now next, first you have to take PU and then add T. So PUT, let's write here PUT, put. Okay, then PUDDING, PUDDING. Now which word is this? Pudding. What is pudding, children? Pudding is a sweet dish. Okay, have you written? Now next, PUG, let's write PUG, pug. Now what is pug? Pug is a breed of dog. That is a type of dog. Okay? Now next. P-U-F-F-I-N. Let's write P-U-F-F-I-N. Puffin. Which word is formed here? Puffin. Now what is puffin, children? Puffin is a seabird. Okay, puffin is a seabird. Now second word, fan. Given letters are GR and we have to add OW in it. So let's write GROW. And the word formed is GROW, grow. Okay? Then again, next word, GR, let's write GROWL, growl. Now children, when dog gets angry, it growls. Okay, understood? Then GRIP, grip. Then write GREEN, green. And then last word GREAT, great. Like this, you have to build the words and write them. Okay? Now let's read this. Read these sentences. The boy has a bag. He has a bag. Now for the boy, we have used here word he. Okay? And he has a bag. Then next sentence is, the girl has a balloon. She has a balloon. Now here, for the girl, she word is used. And she has a balloon. Okay. Next sentence is, the dog has a bone. It has a bone. Now for the dog, it word is used and it has a bone. H-A-S has. Say all of you, H-A-S has. Now turn the page. I have a van. H-A-V-E have. Say all of you, H-A-V-E, have. Ali, Seema and Jaya have cats. They have cats. Pia and I have flowers. We have flowers. So children, we use has with he, she and it. While we use have with I, they and we. This you have to always remember. Okay children? Now let's read the question. Write H-A-S has or H-A-V-E have in the following sentences. First sentence, Rita dash a beautiful doll. Now Rita is a girl, so we have to use the word she for Rita. So she, what you will use for she, has or have? She has, yes. So let's write here H-A-S has. She has a beautiful doll. Now second sentence, he dash gone home. He has gone home. For he we use has. H-A-S has. Are you writing children? Number 3. They dash green bags. They. Now what you will use here? Have or has? They have. Yes. H-A-V-E have. Green bags. Number 4. I dash two books. I have. H-A-V-E have two books. Number 5. This house is mine. It dash two doors. It has two doors. Number 6. We cannot play. We dash an exam tomorrow. Now for we, what you will use children? We have or we has? We have. H-A-V-E have. We use have for the word we. Number 7. This kite is
mine. It dash a long tail. It has H-A-S. It has a long tail. Number 8. Sona and Tina are friends. They dash shoes of the same color. They have H-A-V-E. Have. They have shoes of the same color. My mother likes gardening. She dash lovely plants. She has lovely plants. Number 10. I love bikes. I dash three of them. I have. H-A-V-E. Have. I hope all of you understood this. You have already learned this in active English. Now let's go to the next page. Read this question. Write what is or what are in the blanks. Now children, when we are going to ask the question, we use what is or what are. And then for singular nouns, like for one thing or one person, for one animal, one bird, we use what is. And for many things, many persons, or for many animals, birds, for plural nouns, we use what are. Now here you can see the picture of a one book or picture of a book. So here how you will ask the question, what is this? Got it? And the answer will be, it is a book. Okay, so let's write here. Write W capital, W H A T, what? Say all of you, W H A T, what? I S is. What is this? Now here you can see the picture of a penguin, a single penguin. So again, how you will ask the question? What is this? Right? This is a penguin. So write W capital and then what? W H A T, what is this? What is this? Now here you can see two flowers. That means many flowers. So how you will ask the question? What are these? As these are many flowers, you will ask the question, what are these? And answer will be, these are flowers. Got it, children? So write capital W H A T, what? A R E R, what are these? Now here again you can see many bags. So what, how you will frame the question, children? What you will use here? What is or what are? As you can see here, many bags, the question will be, what are these? So let's write W H A T, what? A R E R, what are these? And answer will be, these are bats. Now here you can see only one dog. Okay, picture of a one dog. So our question will be, what is this? What is this? This is a dog. and here you can see many dogs. So how you will ask the question? What are these? What are these? These are dogs. Now turn the page. Describing words. Look at these pictures. A red kite, a green tree, a big elephant, a little mouse, a fat cat, a beautiful girl. The words marked in red above. Red, green, big, little, fat, beautiful, tell us something more about the nouns kite, tree, elephant, mouse, cat and girl respectively. These are called describing words. Okay, so here red, green, big, little, fat, beautiful, all these are describing words. Now let's read the question. Use words from the box to describe the nouns given. Okay, so describing words, describe the noun. Now given describing words are toy, tall, small, yellow, thin and high. Now number one, you can see here picture of a giraffe. Now how you will describe this giraffe? By using the describing word from the box. Describe this giraffe, children. How is it? Tall. Tall giraffe. Am I right? Okay, so write T-A-L-L, tall, and cut it from the box. Next page, number 2. B-A-L-L, ball. Now see the picture of a ball and describe it. What is the color of the ball? Yellow. You can see here in the box. Y-E-L-L-O-W, yellow. Okay. So cut it off and write here. Y-E-L-L-O-W, yellow. Yellow ball. Now here you can see the picture of a man. See here the given describing words. Toy, small, thin, high. Yes, thin man. So write here T-H-I-N, thin. Okay. Now see the picture of a boat. B-O-A-T, boat. Now how you will describe this boat? Let's read the describing words. Toy, small, high. Small boat. Yes. So cut it off and write here S-M-A-L-L, small boat. Now this is a picture of a wall. W-A-L-L, wall. Now see here the remaining describing words, toy and high. So which word you will use? Toy, T-O-Y, toy, or high? High, H-I-G-H, high. High wall, H-I-G-H, high wall. Now see the picture of a train. It's a toy train. T-O-Y, toy. and strike it off from the box like this. Okay, so like this you have to fill the describing words. Now let's read the next question. Look at the picture and write a few sentences about it. Now children, look at this picture and frame few sentences and write them in your rough book number 9. Okay, so this is a homework. So write here H dot W dot. Now how you will frame the sentences? You can write, there is a house, there is a big garden in front of the house, the boy is watering plants. So like this you can frame sentences and write. Okay children, now let's do the notebook work. Hello children, take out your English notebook number 1. Then take out the next new page and write today's date in the red column. Then see how teacher has written lesson number 14. L dot NO dot 14. Then on the red line you have to write the title of the lesson. Capital T H E the, B I G big, E N O R M O U S enormous, T U R N I P turnip. Then on the first line write dictation words. D I C T A T I O N dictation. Leave some space and write W O R D S words. Then on the next line in the red column write number 1. P L A N T E D planted. Number 2, S P O K E spoke. Number 3, T U R N I P turnip. Number 4, G R O W grow. Number 5, S T R O N G strong. Number 6, E N O R M O U S enormous. Number 7, P U L L E D pulled. Number 8, C A L L E D called. Number 9, W O M A N woman. Number 10, G R A N D D A U G H T E R granddaughter. It's a long spelling, so write it nicely and also learn it nicely. G R A N D D A U G H T E R granddaughter. Number 11, B R O W N brown. Turn the page. Number 12, L A Z Y lazy. Are are you writing children? Number 13, pink, pink. Number 14, again, again. Number 15, little, little. Number 16, happened, happened. Number 17, great, great. Number 18, garden. Number 19, front, front. And number 20, village, village. Like this you have to write 20 dictation words. Then leave one line and on the next line write dictation on 23-2-21. Means your dictation is on 23rd February. Before that you have to learn the spellings of all these words by heart. Okay children, now turn the page. Write Roman number 1. Frame sentences. Capital F R A M E frame. S E N T E N C E S sentences. Number 1, pulled. P-U-L-L-E-D, pulled. Put a dash, small dash. My friend pulled my hair. And underline the word pulled in the sentence. Give the full stop after hair. Leave one line and write number 2, planted, planted, dash, capital W-E-V, planted, some rose plants in our new garden, full stop. Underline the word planted in the sentence. Leave one line, write number 3 in the red column. S-P-O-K-E, spoke, dash, capital I spoke softly with my grandparents. Give full stop, underline the word spoke in the sentence. Leave one line, write number 4 in the red column. STOP, stop. Put a dash, capital THE, the teacher. Next page, write ask the students to stop running in the class. Give full stop, underline the word stop in the lesson. Sorry, in the sentence. Leave one line, write Roman number 2 in the red column. Answer the following. Question number 1. Who planted the turnip?
Put question mark. Next line in the red column, write capital ANS dot answer. The old man planted the turnip. Give full stop, leave one line. Write question number 2 in the red column. Where was the garden? Turn the page. ANS dot answer. The garden was in front of the house. Full stop. Leave one line. Write question number 3 in the red column. Who helped the old man to pull the turnip? Put question mark. ANS dot answer in the red column, write. The old woman, comma, granddaughter, comma, dog, comma, cat, and mouse, mouse, helped the old man to pull the turnip. Give full stop. So like this, children, finish the notebook work also. Okay. Bye-bye. Keep smiling. See you.